Don't pull that innocent seeming coat on me. You see this?
You think you can stop me with that innocent seeming cigarette lighter? I can stop you fast enough.
Not the innocent seeming wristwatch.
That's right, brother.
So you win. But you'll never keep the plans.
Of course I will. They're right here, and they're mine, all mine.
Ha! When they touch an agent from Cali, they self-destruct in 5 seconds.
I should have known! I killed Summers, Gregory, and Jane for those plans, and now they won't get up and smoke. What are you doing?
Just tying my shoelace.
Do you think that innocent-seeming shoelace can stop this innocent shoelace?
That's what it's me for!
Well, in that case...
Not the innocent-seeming tie clasp! This is wrong! All wrong! Chaotic isn't supposed to win!
You didn't write this, brother. This is reality.
Bradley Bruce Benedict, it isn't a good idea to say what's on your mind. Of course, Rodney may be the murderer. He's old and senile, and his mind may have snapped. No, stop it. Every time someone thinks they know who the murderer is, well, that person gets killed. Oh, I'll just say nothing.
Mr. Benedict? Brad?
Sorry, my mind was wandering.
You were just saying that if you said what was on your mind, you wouldn't agree. Just what is on your mind?
Nothing. Not a thing.
Just as I thought.
However, I can make a prediction.
Go ahead. Make it.
Rodney? You're going to be killed next.
Well, that's not a very polite thing to say.
Nevertheless, it follows the pattern.
What pattern?
Rodney.
If you know something and you're not telling us, you're cheating. We're supposed to be collaborating.
Oh, look, here's the first book I ever wrote.
This is no time for narcissism. Now, why did you say I was going to be killed next?
Because you are.
Everybody was wrong about everything tonight.
Thank God for that.
Just get it, boss. Ask a silly question, get a silly answer.
Poison gas capsule sent to a spring in this cut-out book. Ingenious. The murderer knew. It was a foolproof way of getting Brad.
But how any of us could have opened that?
Not that book, honey. It was Brad's first. Remember Lightning Cube?
Oh, God. Yes, it was awful. But he approved after that.
The murderer knew that none of us would dream of opening that book, except for Brad. And of course, he couldn't resist it.
Marvelous, Mildred. Your famed deductive mind works even when you're not writing the story. Keep going.
Oh, I can't think properly with that body messing up the living room. Since there are only two gentlemen left, I suggest they remove Mr. Benedict.
Where to?
How do I know? With the others?
Well, Summers is upstairs, Jane's in the kitchen, Gregory's in the pantry. Well, we'll put him in there. It's closer.
Now things are getting exciting. I must admit to feeling a trifle nervous.
Oh, rock! We're getting down to the nitty-gritty of the whole business. This is when I shine.
Well, I just assumed we figured it out in some comfortable lounge on the mainland.
Oh, we'd only have to come back, return to the scene of the crime and all that.
Well, I for one want to leave Vulture's Vault.
Well, I for two agree with you. How do we go about doing this?
In those movies where a plane crashes on a deserted island, they always write a tremendous help in the sand.
Excellent suggestion.
There's only one thing wrong with it.
What?
No sand. Oh. This island is completely rock.
We'll build a fire.
Out of rocks? Weren't you ever a Boy Scout?
No, they ripped a badge on me when they found my canteen full of martinis.
There is a time when humor is unwelcome, Mr. Oliver. This is one of those times.
The furniture!
I assume that's a non sequitur, Rodney, but you did succeed in changing the subject.
We'll burn the furniture. The smoke will bring help, and we'll write this whole thing up for the television show. Here, I'll take this chair. Oh. Jess, have you got any matches?
Yes.
Okay, Whitney, could you manage that table?
Well, I've been found under smaller ones, but I'll try.
I must say, I have very little faith in this scheme. Me too.
Well, what's wrong with it?
It's too simple.
too simple. If this would work, then everyone would have done it in all our books.
Well, maybe we never thought we'd have them try it.
Oh, I'll answer that when I figured it out.
God, this table's like snow, you little bird.
Pile them over there.
If the fly gets going, I'll look in the water for some marshmallows.
Ow! Damn thing! Oh!
What's the matter?
Oh, a bee stung me.
Where? Let me see.
Oh.
I'll make some love. That's the best thing.
Here.
Oh.
Oh, it's bad, isn't it?
Oh, come along.
Very.
Come along, Rodney. Jessica's made some beautiful mud. If you don't use it on your face, she'll put it on her face. Now, come on.
It hurts.
Of course it does, Rodney, but you're a brave boy.
Goodbye, Rodney Dupkin. You were one of my favorite authors. Bee sting, indeed. I used that one in the case of the South American headhunter. I know a blowgun dart when I see one. Dipped in Ferrari, no doubt. They always are. The unusual weapon. Right up my line. Mildred, my girl, go to it. Now, for the surprise ending. The murderer is not Jessica, because she was helping Rodney with the chair. It's not Whitney, because he was piling the table on top of the chair. Therefore, by process of elimination, the murderer is me! How's that for a surprise ending? No, I know I didn't do it. And if it isn't me, it must be one of those olives. Intriguing idea, you know. Just like I constructed. Down to three people and one of them is guilty. How would I conclude? The olives will come in and announce, all surprised myself, Rodney is dead from a blowgun. Yes, that's how we begin.
Mildred, it's Rodney!
What about him? He's dead!
It wasn't a bee sting, it was a dart from a blowgun.
The kind of murder you would commit. Well, what do you know? Confess, Mildred. Then the three of us will sit down and write a story before you give yourself up.
Oh, royalties will be fantastic.
We'll make sure that your next of kin gets your share. How generous of you, but you've forgotten one thing.
Got that right.
Yes, you've forgotten that I know I didn't do it, therefore it must be you.
We forgot about that.
I thought you'd reckon without my deductive mind.
How true.
But why did you do it?
Well, surely you can figure that.
We're dried up. No new idea in ages. Our books are getting pedantic.
Sloppy.
Predictable. The only way they'll sell is to get rid of the competition.
Yes, we're ridding the world of all mystery authors, one by one.
We're quite insane.
Utterly, completely mad.
I should have guessed. Well, there's only one thing left to do, isn't there?
What's that?
Kill me, of course. I didn't say that. You didn't hear me. Tell me you didn't hear me.
We heard you.
Put that down, Whitney. It's my turn.
It's not.
If so.
It's not.
Why don't you two figure it out while I go upstairs and freshen up?
Stay where you are.
All right, darling, we'll do it together.
Agreed. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Whitney! There. That's a surprise ending. But it won't work in reality, will it? It's stupid and silly, and I'd rip it out of my typewriter. The truth is, no one can predict reality. I'll just have to find out like one of my readers does. They must be about to come back saying,
Mildred, it's Rodney!
What about him? He's dead!
What's the bee sting?
The dart from a blowgun, I know. Of course you knew. It's your kind of murder.
It may be the kind of murder I think up here, but it's not the kind I commit. I'm not the murdering type.
Neither are we.
But one of you must be. Or both. I was thinking just now, and... Oh, nothing. Just that I had an idea.
Give me that after I search.
Oh, let her keep it, Jess. You can't use your master charge here.
I knew she was a murderer, but I had no idea she was a person. Aha!
Just as I thought.
It's not your shade.
Think you can fool an old hen like me? Take that.
She's completely crackers.
If you're hungry, there's food in the kitchen. It's just lipstick. Surprise, surprise. Then how did you do it? Where's the blowgun? We might ask you the same question.
Yes, why did you do it?
Me?
Well, it wasn't either of us, it had to be you.
Either of you? Why not both of you?
You honestly think we'd go around killing people? Why don't you go away somewhere?
Oh, no. I'm not falling for that line. I'm staying right here where I can keep an eye on you.
And we're staying right here and doing ditto.
How long before one starves to death?
I'd die of thirst long before.
Well, I, for one, am not going to waste time. There's money to be made out of this situation, and I'm going to get it. I'm going to break into magazines with this one. Serial rights there, movie rights. My baby.
finish it in jail.
Damn, typewriter won't work. You are old-fashioned, Mildred. It's electric. Oh, thank you. What's the fun? Oh, yeah.
Go ahead, don't let us disturb you.
You seem a little over-anxious for me to start. Of course, ingenious. Now what?
Electricity. Typewriter's rigged. You electrocute me.
Oh, well, really?
You think I'd bother with that? With the ingenious word is I write?
This has gone too far. Even if we were guilty, do you think we'd ever think of anything as stupid as that?
Stupid? One of my best murders was the electric heater in the bathtub.
Here,
I'll type for you.
Whitney.
Yes, dear?
By some odd chance, you didn't read this, did you?
Jessica!
Just ask. N-A-R-T-I-N-I.
Yeah, Mildred, it's all yours.
Well, it was a good idea. Use it sometime.
A Night of Horror by Mildred Zen.
It was me!
Is she dead?
Well, everyone else is. She must be. Dead as a doornail. Oh, God, I hated that line.
The mother knew it would kill her. She's the only one that would type a letter said.
She short-circuited the typewriter, too.
At least she went out writing. That's rather poetic, isn't it?
Oh, my God.
What is it, darling?
Then it's you.
I was just thinking the same thing about you.
Why did you do it?
I didn't.
You must have. I didn't.
Of course you did. There's no one but me, and I didn't do it.
You're having pangs of remorse. That's good.
Oh, I'm not crying. It's having pangs.
Then why?
This is the first time you've ever kept anything from me.
I've never kept anything from you.
What do you call six murders? Nothing? Oh, our marriage is over.
It was based on trust and understanding and mutual faith, and now you've lied to me!
I could say the same thing about you.
No, you couldn't. I'm innocent.
So am I.
I don't believe you.
Look at me. Look at this face.
I've always liked that face, even the peculiar parts of it.
Peculiar parts?
One eye is different from the other, and your nose isn't quite what it should be.
Well, I like that. I've never complained about you through all your years of hair colors.
Oh! I was only doing it to please you.
Now look, you've always known when I was lying. Now look at me. I didn't commit those beastly murders.
I believe you. Oh, wait, darling, I believe you.
Now tell me something.
What?
Why would you commit them?
Oh, I didn't! I didn't! I swear, on our next royalty check.
Honestly?
Cross my heart and hope to die. No, I didn't say that. I'd take that back.
Well, if everyone here is dead except us, I think we've finally come upon the perfect crime.
I always said it could be committed.
I think we should celebrate.
The wine.
Excellent. I hope it's a good year.
I do feel rather a fool having suspected you, darling.
Oh, think nothing of it. I suspected you too.
What are we going to do now? Sit here drinking until the launch comes.
Get delightfully tipsy.
How can I keep a happy outlook on our work after tonight?
This might happen.
It's bound to.
To our greatest mystery yet to come.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, that wasn't a good year at all.
It wasn't even a good month.
Do you suppose it was made from grapes or onions?
Bitter and acrid. That's what it tastes like. Where have I heard that before?
You wrote it in the Poison Corpse, remember?
That's right. The wine was bitter and acrid. Jess.
Wit.
Jess, the murderer knew we'd drink this.
Damn.
Don't be upset. We'll go together, darling.
It's not that, but we don't know who did it.
That is rather upsetting.
Oh. It's like turning the last page of a mystery book and having it say, guess who?
Don't worry. We'll find out in that great library in the sky.
Do you think they'll have all our books?
Bound and Goldie.
And we'll pick up the Times and be at the top of the bestseller lists every Sunday.
Heavenly.
Exactly.
But I can't wait. I want to know who did it now.
So do I, darling.
What's that noise?
Oh, wait. Someone's coming. We're going to get our last wish. We'll find out who did it.
I'm too tired to turn my head.
Will you stop dragging your feet and hurry up?
more.
Don't you like it?
Dirty pool! Oh, such dirty pool! He's been done to death! The first one killed is the murderer.
Oh. I'm sure you were dead when we carried you upstairs.
I was.
Oh, I love science fiction.
Jason Summers was dead, but I'm Grady Summers.
Oh my God, this is even worse. The twin brother, I assume.
That's correct.
Dirty pool, such dirty pool.
After you two are gone, I shall have done the perfect crime.
But why?
My brother Jason always had everything. I had nothing.
Oh God, I have worse speeches like this.
Explanatory and they're long and boring.
Hear me out. When Jason told me of his plan to bring you here and how he'd come up with the greatest murder script in history.
Oh, I know, and you were going to do one better.
So you committed real murders.
How did you know?
We write these things.
We used to write them. Oh, which I can't take any long speech from him. I'm going right now.
But it's my right to say something. I mean, every murderer gets to tell how he did it, step by step.
No, not this time, old boy. Sorry, but we've got to leave. That's the way the ball bounces.
But I have so much to say. My murders. I mean, I made history here tonight. I've committed the ultimate in crime. This is the perfect mystery.
Oh, I don't think so.
It doesn't have any punch at the end.
Yeah, rewrite it needs a tremendous rewrite.
I think it's excellent.
No, no, Mr. Summers. You don't know anything about it. We are the experts. Come back in now.
Suspense is terrific.
Oh, the characters aren't any good.
You can't combine all those styles into one coherent work.
I heard everything from offstage.
If we bring Jack Club in after the first word.
Jack Club is out. He was good in his time.
Perhaps we made him a man from the CIA.
Oh, people are tired of that.
Aren't you?
Yeah. Drop me, darling. They still think we're on the island.
Oh, you don't, do you?
Of course they do. We told them we were moving from the studio to the island. We turned off the lights. We turned them back on again, and naturally they thought we were on the island.
Just because we said so?
Of course.
What a fabulous group you are. Try to go,
if we work any longer, we'll have to go in overtime, and the union's quite...
I'm well aware of the union. I'll write you out a check immediately.
I hope you're pleased with our parts.
Oh, you were marvelous, darling.
When you finish your scripts in the audition?
Of course.
We won't be above scale.
Well, I'll have to talk to my agent.
We don't want to keep the audience any longer, do we?
Oh, heavens, no. They'd be bored to death with the rewrites.
Well, thank you all very much for coming tonight. Your reactions have been a big help. You see, before we came here, we got together at that restaurant across the way, and we decided that this would be the best thing to do, to pretend we really were still on the island. Even Jason Summers liked the idea, and he did turn in a reasonably good performance.
I used to do a little community theater work.
Who really give them their money's worth?
Oh, of course, darling. 8 murders. What did they expect? World War III?
So go home now and don't worry about a thing. Murders all in books and stories. It can happen here.
What's that?
It came from over there.
It's a woman.
Another improvisation. Shouted real to me.
What is it? What's happening?
It's that girl from the box office.
She's ill.
Stop it! She's dying!
Quiet, let her speak.
Poison in the refreshments.
let's have some warm-up. We're doing some warm-up.
Folks, we appear to be on camera here,
no? No swearing.
There's the worst thing to say.
There's a familiar face.
That's the worst thing to say. Yeah, that, isn't it a tough face? Look at the toughness, the severity of it. It's just hard as nails.
We're reading, this is what we do for the show.
Do a siren, tough rod.
I hear nightingales.
Neat New York. Neat rubber baby buggy bug.
Rubber baby buggy bug. Rubber baby buggy bug.
This is Blake's role.
This is Frank. Everybody, this is Frank.
Frank was here tonight.
Everywhere.
Is that a video camera? Oh, what is that machine you have there? Why is someone poking me? Ugh.
What this play is all about?
I'll die later. Are we on?
This is Aaron.
If I had it, I would have worn black tie.
I smell better.
Blake, if I had known we'd been taping tonight, I would have worn black tie.
Good thinking there, buddy.
This is Mildred Zed Maxwell, by the way. How do you do? I'm
Is that a martini you're asking?
Yes, I'd like a very dry martini, please.
There you go, sir.
Thank you.
It's in a proper martini glass as well.
Oh God, that's good booze.
Yes.
You know the sweepstakes machine.
This is my one.
This is Melanie in torture.
Too late.
Oh wait, no, I have something to say. Oh, don't deny me my 15 seconds of fame. No, this is my one chance to talk in the play. I have to mime everything, right? So I better get it all out now while I can, right? I'm allowed to speak. I have to use my voice. Very good. Thank you very much. So I just want to say to all those people out there, hi, come to the show. What is this? Is this going to be aired anywhere?
No.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ray Tower.
Oh, that lazy river. Where the old man is. That lazy river.
Does the word camp come to mind?
This is what you call camp.
Camp.
You and Funk, there we are.
There's a reason. My body's consciously changing.
You're invisible.
Yes. No. Oh, are you fixing my hair?
No.
I've only. And, that's as many lines as he has in the. No, no, he's got some other lines. Hit the music, Lisa. Actually, you could watch.
Have to put your initials on your cup.
You could watch the transformation of this tough bitch over here. With what you're.
It would.
Shut your doll.
How much tape do you have on that? You have enough room for all this drink?
I'm gonna switch mine around and do the mole voice for the maid. The maid's voice for the mole.
How many out there, Garrett?
Oh, hundreds.
Jared, this is a free show.
There's 12 out there.
Hello. Are we allowed to drink in the aisles?
Are we allowed to answer?
No, drink?
Yes.
She's so tough, they gotta spray her hair with a napalm.
She's so filming.
I'll get a little music on.
I didn't say that. You didn't hear me.